As pet guardians, it can be worrying and confusing to figure out exactly when we should take our pets to the doctor. Today I'm going to be talking about when to take your pet to the vet. Seek immediate emergency treatment if your pet is suddenly lethargic or comatose, your pet is repeatedly vomiting and can't hold down water or food for even 10 minutes, your pet has had an obvious trauma with something like a fracture or a wound. You should go to the vet if your pet loses consciousness, or if your pet has difficulty breathing or is wheezing. If your pet is drooling a lot and it doesn't coincide with a car ride or a particularly stressful event, make sure you get to the vet. Also go to the vet right away if your pet has blood in their vomit, if your pet is having seizures, if they're constantly screaming, crying, or shaking, or if your pet has a hard or swollen abdomen. Lastly, be sure to take your pet to the vet if they're demonstrating sudden, extreme aggression towards other dogs or people. But please be very careful not to get bit. In some cases, you can wait 24 hours and see if your pet gets any better. If after 24 hours they haven't improved, make sure you take your pet to the vet if they're not eating or drinking for over 24 hours or not eating for over 48 hours. If they exhibit extreme drooling coinciding with a stressful event, which doesn't go away. If your pet vomits at least once every 6 hours, it's best to go to the vet for a checkup. If your pet is lethargic and tired and it persists for more than 24 hours. You should also go to the vet if you have a puppy with loose motions for over 24 hours. If your pet has blood in their stool more than once, or if they are too thirsty for over 24 hours, head on in to the vet. Lastly, there are a few more things that can indicate a problem if they persist for more than a few days. Take your pet to the vet if they have reduced appetite for over 4 days, which means they're still eating, but just not very much. If your pet has loose motions for over 3 days. If they lose interest in normal activities, like they're less playful or less excited by walks, for over 4 days. If your pet is limping on one or more limbs for more than 3 days. If your pet demonstrates general grumpiness or unusual aggressiveness towards other dogs or humans. If your pet has sudden weight change, whether rapid weight gain or loss. If they're constantly scooting on their butt, which can indicate blocked anal glands or worms. You should also go to the vet if your pet has a rash or skin problem that persists for over a week, or if your pet begins to urinate in the house if they were house trained before. These symptoms can all indicate a problem that your vet can diagnose and treat. This isn't a comprehensive list, so if you're ever unsure, call your vet, give them your pet symptoms, and ask if they suggest that you bring them in. Do you like YouTube more than you like Instagram or Facebook? Then check out our channel at youtube.com/peoplefarm.